So you just really don't know how exciting your life is going to be until after potluck, and the pastor said, would you like to preach next week? And I guess he just asked me because I just talk all the time anyway, but I said, certainly. Who would pass up an opportunity to tell people how good God is? And so I said, yeah, okay, count me in. You know, the good thing about that is, or there's lots of good things about it, it was a much more blessed week for me than many of the weeks that transpired before, because I spent more time reading God's word, praying, and listening to find out what it was that I should share with you today. So I'm bringing it. Now, and the good news is, because that's how it was done, it doesn't really have to be good. It's good because God will give you the blessing, regardless of what I say. In fact, they did a study and they asked people, what was the sermon about? People walked out the door and they took a survey, exit poll. The answers weren't all the same. They were all in the same room and heard the same sermon and got a different message. And that's because God speaks to your heart individually. The words are the same, but the process and the message that you get is the one that God wants you to hear. So my prayer today is that I don't get in God's way, because then you'll miss your blessing. Okay, well, I have this powerful thing here, which will automatically make pictures show up. And I brought my own box. I wanted you to see what mine looked like. Not that good. Getting a little ragged here on the bottom. It's had to tape that, keep it from falling apart. But this is just for illustration. And hopefully, it'll be something that when you leave, you remember and helps you in your own personal journey to be next to God. So, I apologize if some of it seems just way over the top, but I couldn't help myself. By the way, I have this telecommunications device, which I've heard yours go off in the last three Sabbaths, so I turn mine to the off button, and you can please join me in that spot. So I thought it would be good that that we practice a little bit. That was the one I was looking for earlier and apparently got it out of order. Sorry about that, Vince. That was what you shared with us earlier today. And then this was our song, and now we're back to the start. Okay, so I thought we'd practice some directions. One of them was to turn your cell phone off. And so the other is, I'm going to press the button. A word is going to come on the screen, and your job is to read the word out loud. Who says, I'm not going to do this? This is not, you laugh. When you stand, if you were standing, sometimes you should just ask, Pastor, can I just stand here and watch the congregation while you preach? It would be interesting for sure. It's what you find out if you, because I've stood in front of people probably lots more than Tyler has. Not a congregation. They were all sixth graders, and they were easier to control because I was a lot bigger than them. But if you get the people to follow the directions, you can take them where you want them to go. So it's a stretch, but I am the shepherd, and you are the sheep. That was not in the script. Please, no. Okay. Because here's what happens to most of us. They said, will you follow direction? You say yes. And then the that comes and you don't follow direction. That ever happen to you spiritually? Happens to me probably every day. I find out I'm not worthy. It's frustrating. The good news is Jesus forgives me. That's the exciting news. That's the news you're going to hear about today. But it is frustrating that I know the rules and somebody said to do what the rules said, and then I just, I'll do them tomorrow would be more convenient. Okay. You ready? Yeah. Okay, that's not the slide that was supposed to be there. That's the people in the booth messing with me. And Zachary, you and I are going to meet in the parking lot. Yeah. So, trust me, the slide was there. And it would have been good if it had worked. But if you know about technology, so I'm at home with my little old computer and using the PowerPoint, and I type it on there. I spent hours doing this, typing the word amen. Amen. And that was the slide you were supposed to see. And all the people said?
Amen.
That was good. And the other slide, these are words I just stole, plagiarized right out of the Bible. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Okay, well, I'm glad you were good-humored about that. So, on my thumb drive, it's perfect. But it came out of my machine, and you take it to somebody else's machine, you plug it in there, and for some reason, it just doesn't work. What does your book blocks look like? And yours, like mine, maybe somebody may have been kicking around a little bit. So, you might have some bumps and scratches on yours, whatever. But what your box looks like, you're actually in control of. So let's look at some of the things. We have some inputs into the box. And, okay, these are all inputs in your box. What in the world are you doing with these inputs? Think about this. In your brain, it stores all of the inputs. There's no lack of space to store these inputs. There's so much in there you can't remember them all or access them. But have you never been somewhere and all of a sudden you remembered something and it just like played a video for you of something that happened in the past? It's all in there. Do you control what you see? Not 100%, but a lot of it. And I'm here to tell you that depending on what you're putting in there, is going to be what your box looks like. Here's the outputs. I put the porta potty on there because I knew the kids here would just be, if I didn't address all the outputs, they would say you didn't cover everything. And then I put that handshake in there. Are you offering people a helping hand? And then I put my happy face on there. I was going to wear that tie, but since I had the picture up here, it was all good. And then there's that fist thing. And then there's that guy. More technology. That S was in the right place when I put it up there. It just says worthless. Do you know who the most valuable person in this room is? The answer is, there isn't one. Each person in this room has exactly the same value. Priceless. Are you not also a child of God? Makes you priceless. Now, somebody may have said, you're worthless. They were lying to you. Probably to make themselves feel better. talking about this box, about how good you look. Who is the best looking person in the room? Well, I used this in sixth grade, and the answer was it was me. And of course, all the children laughed. And the point I was trying to make was, this is a covering that I got from my biological parents. It's for identification only. I was talking about my character. And my character, I told the children, was supposed to be better than theirs because I had been working on it longer. Worked really well for them. So there are so many people in here with much better character than me. That didn't work. What you look like to people and how good you look like to them is all about your character. Because your character changes the way you treat them. The people of the good character have the smile on their face and they have their hand out to help you. The scripture this morning, the man said, the one who had mercy on him. How many of you knew that was from the preamble to the Good Samaritan story? Okay, that's where I'm going to end up with that. So if you caught that already, good on you. So here's the box, and what does yours look like? It looks like whatever is in it, which is your character. And there's only one thing that can improve it. And we're going to go visit there today. And I'm going to invite you to go with me. I got this when it's the road less traveled picture. About which place do you pick to go? So we'll have a little brief intermission to see if you're the... That didn't work. Press play there for me, son.
You told me last Sunday morning, son, you better start living right. You need to quit the women and whiskey and carrying on all night. Don't you want to hear them call your name when you're standing at the pearly gates? I told the preacher, yes, I do. Everything I did last night and one to get me through today. Here's a tin to help you remember next time you got the good Lord's ear. Say I'm coming, but there ain't no hurry. I'm having fun down here. Don't you know that everybody wants to go to heaven, get their wings and fly around. Everybody wants to go. Nobody wanna go now. Someday I wanna see those streets of gold with my halo. But I wouldn't mind waiting at least 100 years or so. Everybody wanna go to heaven. At least the other place there ain't no doubt. Everybody wanna go. Everybody wanna go to heaven.
Maybe. The sad part is, that's all of us. The song was about us. Ask yourself if you go, I want to go to heaven, but I can't find it. I'm not really looking. I'm waiting for a better time. Heaven's here. You're going to see it today. We'll show you how you can find it yourself. But you have to want to go. So, you're going to go to heaven. It's inside of you. And so you have to look inside there. And it's full of stuff. Not unlike this Where's Waldo maze. And you have to look for it. And you have to search for it. Remember, all the stuff that's in here, everything that you saw, everything that you heard, all of that stuff's in there, and it's blocking your view. Maybe you need a reason. To the listening ear, I speak. To the waiting heart, I come. Sometimes I do not speak. I may ask you merely to wait in my presence, to know that I am with you. Think of the multitudes who thronged me when I was on earth, all eager for something. Eager to be healed, to be taught, to be fed. Think as I supplied their many wants and granted their manifold request, what it meant to me to find amid the crowd some one or two who followed me just to be near me, just to dwell in my presence. How some longing of the internal heart was satisfied thereby. Comfort me a while by letting me know that you would seek me just to dwell in my presence, to be near me, not for teaching, not for material gain, not for a message, but for me. The longing of the human heart to be loved for itself is something caught by the great divine heart. Does your heart long to be with God? You might be lost. But if you go inside yourself and you wait and you find your heart, the missing piece of all of us is God. Without him, there's always something dissatisfying about life. But if you go there and you wait, God is there inside. In those pictures, I always thought God was trying to not to get into my heart. What I never realized is that God was already there, and he was knocking for me to let him out. We're at the door. Will you go in? Sanctuary is in here. This is the sanctuary. So before we go in, let's wait a moment, close our eyes, and prepare our hearts to go into the sanctuary. Amen. If you walk in near to the heart of God, the Holy Spirit that's in each one of us. In the Holy of Holies, you read in the Old Testament, people that walked in there were certainly somebody that was as miserable as I am, a person. But because of Jesus' love for me, to clear my heart so that I can be in the presence of the Holy Spirit. Being there, waiting there. For no other person, no other purpose than that you love God. In the scripture, prior to the part we read today, was they wanted to know how they could get to heaven. What must I do? Love God with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your soul, and all your strength. And love your neighbor as yourself. It's hard to love your neighbor. If you're finding it hard to love your neighbor, you might want to think about seeing if you could love God more. That's where all the power is. Do you not think you would be changed if each day you went to the place? They talked about praying in the closet. I put these on. And sometimes when I'm reading the scripture and then your mind wanders away because it's just got so much stuff in there, I start reading out loud. Because I want to get to the spot where I'm not thinking of anything else but God. It's a sweet place to be. It's a wonderful place to be. And while you're there, and you're sitting there in front of with God, where you would think, I could never get there. Nobody would ever let me go. But God wants you to come and be with Him in that place. I don't know if your experience would be the same, but you might have inside there, you might end up being changed as well. I don't own God. God loves me. I just want to get to where that's where I want to be. Is He waiting? Come visit. Do you not realize that you would have been broken under the weight of your cares? Okay, that didn't work out as well as I liked. I held the button, my bad. Oh, back up. Oh, stop pressing, okay. So, well, while they're fixing that technical stuff, I bought this book originally at Barnes & Noble for $2. It was on the sale thing, and I felt sorry for the book. And I felt, because I thought, why should a book about God be something people just didn't want. And so I bought it, and then I took it home and didn't read it. Anybody ever done that before? And so then I started reading this book. And the book, I don't know who wrote it, because the people who wrote it said, don't tell. Two ladies, 1930s, London. They were on a mission, and their mission was, does God really come and visit with people like he did in the Old Testament, where it said, where two or more are gathered together, I will be with you? They wondered if that was still true. It's not. It may not be anymore, but in 1930, with these ladies, it's still true now. It's always been true, because God is still here. We just don't go visit him that often. So they started praying, and then they would write down, while they were waiting in God's presence, what they thought God told them. Pretty soon, they started writing down the same thing. And that's what's in this book. That's what was up here on the screen. It's not for everybody, but it's the best, most helpful perspective I have run across since the Bible. I've read lots of great books. They're wonderful. But this thing talks about how sweet it is to be right up next to God. If you want one, you have to ask me for it later. I have 100 of them. I just buy them by the gross and just give them away. So if you think, having heard today whatever you heard, that you think this may help you on your own journey, then I'll be happy to give you this. So, fortunately, maybe we're back here. I apologize, because on my book and my thing, you could actually read that. Do you not realize that you would have broken down under the weight of your cares, but for the renewing time with me? It is not what I say, it is I myself. It is not the hearing me so much as the being in my presence. The strengthening and curative powers of this you cannot know. Such knowledge is beyond your human reckoning. This would cure the poor, sick world if every day each soul or group of souls waited before me. Remember that you must never fail to keep this time apart with me. Gradually, you will be transformed physically, mentally, spiritually into my likeness. All who see you or have contact with you by this intercourse with you brought near to me, and gradually the influence will spread. You are making one spot on earth a holy place, and through you must work and spend yourself ceaselessly, for that is for the present your appointed task. Yet the greatest work that either of you can do and are doing is done in this time apart with me. Are you understanding that? Do you know that every thought, every activity, every prayer, every longing of the day is gathered up and offered to me now? Oh, joy that I am with you. For this I came to earth, to lead men back to the spirit converse with God. The goal for me is that when you look at my box, you see Christ. That only happens if I spend time with God, because that's the only thing that changes my character. God is good all the time, but he's better if you spend personal time with him, which is how you get good. And that your box will start to look like Christ himself. It's getting rid of the I and putting God first. It's a struggle every day. I'm struggling with you on that same journey. May God bless you and keep you. May God shine His light upon you and give you peace. Amen.